When it comes to comparing fly versus jerkbait fishing, there is a big difference in how the fishing is done. And I see people struggle with this when they come on a guiding with me. Fly fishing for pike, it is to handle and land fish when it is vegetation or weed beds, reeds on the shoreline, anything like that. Today, we're gonna talk all about maximizing our chances to land that pike on the fly rod. And perhaps for the jerkbait anglers, can be interesting to see the other perspective of the struggles and the challenges there is with fishing with a fly rod for pike. In the modern fly fishing, you can fish really the most weedy areas, actually, especially thanks to a lot of development in hooks made for these kind of scenarios to fish in really weedy places. So there are good weedless options for flies, but that's not the main concern. Doing a hook set with a low water-resistant braided line and a really stiff rod, you have a much more capable rod of getting a fast contact with the pike and getting it lifted up from the grass. Compare that to a very thick fly line and usually a much softer fly rod. And you understand that already from the moment it takes. It is about to get a good tension in the line or set the hook, which you do with, not with a rod like you see jerkbait anglers do. They make a big hook set. What you do is instead you make the hook set with a line. So you strip set, you continue the stripping in and hold the rod down until you feel a really strong and heavy weight of the pike. Then you can just a little bit lift the rod so you have quite a low bend on it. There is the good hook set of a pike, but it needs to be really firm and quick because you don't want to let it down into the grass or swim around some reeds or so. This is really crucial, especially with the fly rod. The other challenge with using a fly rod comes from the same reason. And I'm sure you back home can picture this problem occur. So you are out there doing the retrieve and you have a big pike taking your fly. You make a good hook set, and then what? What happens? There is gonna be a battle. If I take you to the place where we film the Fly TV Mountain Mamas, there is a lot of vegetation. In that moment, it goes so quick to that you don't have any contact with the pike anymore. It can still be on, but wherever direction it goes, if it goes away from you or to the side or anything, if the fly line ever so slightly catches a few straws of grass, then there will be such a big curve on the fly line where like a thinner braided line will just cut through it and you will still have the contact with it. It is really tough. If the line is starting to catch on straws of grass, then you're in big problem. And this is the moment when I see my guiding guests struggle the most. It's when they have a big fish on and they have the fish catching some grass or the line catching some grass. They lose the contact with the fish and the fly is out of the fish mouth. That's so common, and I just wanna, yeah, that's the main thing I wanna do with this video. Just share this, you practice this mindset before you come out and do the fishing in the grass areas, so you don't get to this scenario. So I'm gonna share how I managed to improve my catches and landing percentage in these scenarios. And it's about taking the fish home really firmly. But I have a little small hack about the equipment before we go on to that. So here I have a full setup for the pike fishing, but without the rod. It was more easy to do in here. Beginning with a big black fly, like similar to what was working so well in my last pike fishing video. Link for it will be, of course, in the end of the video. So here you have a coated wire leader. And then you have a nylon or fluorocarbon leader, which goes to the fly line. This distance is now about 1.5 meters in total. And then comes this thick fly line. For like an easy turnover of the casts, you want a quite a short leader. But the shorter this part is, the closer the fly line comes and can catch the grass. So technically, for fishing in these grassy areas, if you would have a 7 meter leader, it would be more capable to cut through the grass like the jerkbait fishermen can do. 7 meters is not gonna be possible to turn over the flies at all, I can tell you that. But why not challenge it a little bit? Just put on a piece of leader that is too long, and then progressively you make it shorter and shorter until you're able to cast it in a decent way. And then you fish with that. If you come and fish in the grass areas, similar to in the Mountain Mamas, for example, then that can be a really useful trick, so you have less of a disadvantage compared to the jerkbait anglers. But on to how to fight the fish. So, many people just think, okay, you just tighten the brake and then you're fine. I mean, then you will fight it hard. But the thing is, when you're fly fishing, you are retrieving the line with your hands. So what happens when the fish takes, you have a lot of line just laying around in the boat or in your line basket. And in this small window of opportunity you have to land this fish, when it bites in thick vegetation, there is no way you can reel in this line if it's a lot, or even if it's just a few meters. I would say no way. What you need to do in these scenarios is to fight the fish by hand. To really hold a firm grip on the line. So I should have a rod handle here. Anyways, I hold the rod, squeeze the line against it, and just don't let the line slip out. And just bring it in to the net as fast as possible. And as I said, you hold the rod down when you make the hook set. So you have the weight of the pike. But then to put as much pressure as you can on the pike with a fly rod, which is not super stiff, you kind of want to have a semi-low angle, not really high up. And because the rod would mostly just flex, you will be tired in your arm, but the rod is just flexing a lot. That's what tiring your arm. You're not really bringing in the fish like you would if you would really hold a little bit lower angle and then bring the fish in with the retrieving hand. That's the way to do. And if the fish is trying to swim away from you down into the grass, you just squeeze even harder and you can break even the biggest fish if you're strong enough and if there is no weakness in the links. I mean, the modern fly lines, like this grandmama line, you can get stuck in a 50 kilo or 70 kilo log and just pull it up from the bottom. So you need to make sure that the leader and the wire and the hook is strong enough to stop the fish from going where it wants to go. If you fish with like a big single hook, then you can really stop the pike. Hope you enjoyed this little comparison with jerkbaits versus fly. Thank you very much for watching. Look at my pike videos on the channel. And yeah, see you soon.